Hi and welcome back, it's Vicky here, and today I'm going to create a really adorable card using a new released product. This is the Merry Moose die set by Sizzix, and it is designed by Tim Holtz. And this moose really makes me smile. So anyway, I'm going to take it out of the packaging so you can see what you get with this die set. There are actually 7 dies included. There is a big one that cuts out the moose, another one that cuts out a tree. And I like that you get a tree here, since it is very versatile and you can use it for other cards as well. And there are also tiny little dies that cut out the leaves for your tree, or a little bell, a collar for your moose, little pieces that you can actually paper piece. Now here is how I like to store my dies on this envelope that comes with the die. And now you can either use cardstock that is already colored, like I am going to do today, to cut out all the little pieces and then paper piece them together, or you can use white cardstock to cut out everything and then just use your markers or any other coloring medium to color them up. I used cardstock from these two pads. These are 8x8, and one of them is metallic with gold and silver, and the other one has a bunch of colors. For cutting out everything, I will be using my Sizzix Big Shot, and this is actually the fold-away model. This has the exact same opening as the regular Big Shot, but it is more compact when you want to store it and put it away. So I'm just going to place as many of the dies as I can, and I'm going to place my cutting pad on top and just run it through. Now the fun part about this fold-away machine is that it has a pocket there, so I can store my craft pick, which I always use with my Big Shot machine when I die cut. Now I'm going to take out all the images, and I will repeat the same process a couple of times more, since I need to have 3 trees and some bits and pieces with different colors. Now here, as you can see, I have all the pieces cut out already, and now I'm going to add a little bit of inking with Ground Espresso, which is slightly darker than my cardstock, at the bottom of my moose. This is going to give it just a touch of shading, and I will repeat the same process for the antlers as well by using Vintage Photo. Little touches like this really make a difference on a card. Now it's time to do some paper piecing and put my little moose together. So for that I will be using my white glue. This is Nouveau Deluxe, and I'm going to stick on top the antlers with different colored cardstock. Now I will go ahead and start sticking down everything. So here I'm preparing the collar, which consists of 2 pieces. I have cut out the top one with red cardstock, and the bottom is gold. So when I place one on top of the other, you will be seeing that gold shining through the holes. And it's the exact same thing with the bridle, where I have cut it out of red cardstock, and now I'm just sticking a couple of dots that I have cut out of gold. And now I'm working on the tree. I'm just sticking down the leaves. You are not supposed to cover up all the branches, just add a few of the leaves here and there. Now I have finished off with putting together the 3 trees, and now it's time to finish off my moose. So I'm going to stick down the collar, and for the collar there is also a tiny little bell that I have cut out of gold cardstock, and I'm going to finish off my moose by sticking down the bridle. Now as always, you will find the full list of all the supplies that I'm using today down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. So now my little moose is ready. And I'm going to work on my trees. For that I will be using texture paste, because I want to make them as if they are full of snow. I'm going to apply the snow with my spatula at the top of the branches. I will repeat the same process for all the branches for all 3 of the trees. Don't try to make them perfect. Snow isn't perfect when it falls on top of the trees. And the truth is that this texture paste is perfect for creating the snow texture. It's nice and fluffy when it dries, and it gives a perfect effect. While my trees are drying, I'm going to create a background for my little scene. So I'm going to ink up this white cardstock with Distress Oxide inks. I will be mixing up 3 colors. The lighter one that I'm using right now is Broken China, And then I will move on to faded jeans on the other side. And as I come towards the broken china colored one, you will see that I'm going to go softer and blend those two colors. Now, as you can see at the moment, I do have splotches, but I don't care. Distress Oxide ink blends beautifully. And even when you get splotches, you can always go on top of it again and again until you get a smooth finish. Now I'm going to introduce a third color, which is quite darker. This is Chipped Sapphire, and it's one of the latest colors that have been released. I am inking only the top part with a darker color, making sure that everything is nice and blended, and I'm going to call the inking done. Now I will move on and add some snow on my background scene. And although I do have stencils with snow, I didn't have one that it was quite fine as I wanted to for this card. So for that I used a die that comes from this Sizzix die set. This is the die that comes with the deer. And I have cut out my very own stencil. Now of course you can cut it out of acetate, so you can reuse this stencil again and again. I didn't bother, I just cut it out of cardstock, and I will go ahead and apply my texture paste. Once this is dry, I will move on towards the bottom and repeat the same process one more time so that I have snow falling all the way to the bottom of my background. Now I used white cardstock and cut out two slopes that I can place one on top of the other with foam squares. This way I have a couple of layers and I have a lovely snowbank. Now you can use this as it is or take it a step further like I will do. So I'm going to use my texture paste, and with a spatula I'm going to completely cover those two pieces of cardstock. This way I will get that snow effect, and it's going to have the same texture as my background, the snow at the background, as well as the snow on top of my trees. You can see that it is really easy to spread it out, just like butter on a piece of bread. Now at this stage everything is ready, so it's time to put my card together. I will start by placing down the trees, and I will make sure that some of them will look as if they are far at the background, while others are at the front. And I'm also making sure that the way I stick them down don't look as they have all the same height. This way they will not look identical, although they actually are. Now my snowbank is in place, and it's time to add the last tree, which is going to go in between the two layers of the snowbanks. So I have created a lovely winter wonderland scene, and you can stick on top as a focal point so many different things that you probably have. For now I will go with the moose, but I love the trees and I know that I will be using them a lot for other cards as well. And to finish it off, I'm going to add a sentiment that is actually a sticker. This comes from the Holiday Talk sticker pack by Tim Holtz. It has tons of holiday sayings in both silver and gold lettering. I went with the gold lettering on top of white, and I also added a piece of foam tape at the back just to level it up with the dimension on my card. And here is my finished project. I absolutely love it. I love all the dimension and that adorable moose. So here are some close-up photos. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to like the video as well as leave me a comment. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.